Thank you all for coming this afternoon. We really appreciate it. And you're in for a real treat of a concert. It's a very wide-ranging concert from the early music of Dardanus Rameau and from this early 1700s through to Dvorak and Beethoven. So it's a good smattering. And of course, that was Mozart. So our soloist for our next piece has been in Jackson probably longer than either one of us care to remember. We've been around a long time here. We came about the same time, and he jokingly calls himself someone in the shadows. He has amazing technique and musicality, but it's always usually overshadowed by the concertmaster. He is the associate concertmaster of the Mississippi Symphony, and of course all the accolades go to the concertmaster. I mean, deservedly so, but still, he jokingly says that he's sort of in the shadows, but we all know his wonderful talent, and we're delighted to show this talent off to you this afternoon. So please welcome Vince Massimino.
Thank you.
now for something completely different, the Dardanus Suite. They're published in two different suites. We put the two together, got rid of some of the harder ones and the ones that, well, a little boring to my taste, but very representative of French opera, which is quite a bit different from the Italian opera that you're used to seeing. You don't see a lot of French opera anymore, unless I guess you're in Paris. They're still continuing. But in the middle 1700s, Rameau really came to fame. The whole French opera sort of developed under Louis XIV, and Lully had dominated an entire century of music before Rameau, and so Rameau was like the second coming of Lully, if you will. And back then, French opera, well, let me compare it to Italian that you know, is a series of arias and recitatives, and then a couple of chorus pieces thrown in. And that's probably most of the opera that you've seen, but French opera is quite a bit different in that it has a lot of dance, it has poetry readings, but an overall storyline through all of that. So it's a big extravaganza, can last for hours to get all the dancers in and all of the singers in and all of that. Well, movements that we're playing some of it is incidental music, between scene changes, things like that, and actual dance movements they would dance to. And so it's a smattering of different things like that. One of the challenges we had in presenting this is, especially in the strings, the style of playing in the strings is quite a bit different. It's a very lighter approach to the playing. There's a lot of ornaments that took a lot of time to work out, little passages or little turns, for those that don't know what the ornaments are, where they belong. Are they ahead of the beat, buddy-a, or is it buddy-a on the beat? So those are things that we all had to work out, and the strings worked really hard at getting all of those things correct, I think I've run out of things to say. Dardanus, 5, 6, 7 movements that I put in there?
Thank you. Thank you. can see right now, I'm not really dressed to perform today. That's because there's no trombones in the romantic pieces that they're playing right now. Which I'm quite surprised by now, because I've always felt that the trombone was a very romantic instrument. And I know for a fact that trombonists are all romantics at heart. So I was taken aback by that a little bit. But it has given me the opportunity to do something I haven't been able to do in a lot of years, and that's sit in your perspective in the audience and actually watch the MCW play. I know how much effort and work has gone into this, and it's really sounding great. I'd like to thank you. The Metropolitan Chamber Orchestra has been giving free performances in the Jackson metropolitan area now for 39 years. And even though the performances themselves are free to the public, they're not free to put on, unfortunately. So we have been very lucky to have been received private donations to keep this particular organization working for their free performances every year for 39 years, primarily from donations from the orchestra, some corporate and grants, but also from donations from you, our patrons. And to that end, we have put an envelope in your program that you can give us a donation if you so feel to. If you give the money into it, you can give it to me or any of the orchestra members if you decide to do something today. Or when you get home and decide you're moved to give us something, then you can drop it in the mail and come right to us. You can also go to our website at mcojackson.org, which is also in your program, and make an electronic donation to us. We sure would appreciate it, as it allows us to put on these programs for you on these beautiful Sunday afternoons. So thank you very much for that. I would like to make one orchestral announcement today. Our principal violinist, Mr. Ryan Rogers, has decided to step down as our concert master following this performance today. And I would just like to publicly say, for the orchestra and everyone, how much we've enjoyed having Ryan as our concert master. It has been a wonderful addition to this group over the last few years, provided his personal, financial, and musical abilities to this group that have helped us every single year that he's been in it. And on a personal note, he has been the concert master as long as I've been on the board of directors and has been president. So I've worked with him quite a bit, and I think he's probably one of the most proactive people I've ever known. If we ever came up with something that we thought Ryan needed to do, he usually had already done it. So we've been very happy to have him here, and of course, he's welcome to come back now and perform with us at any time. And I think I can say for the board and for the whole orchestra that there will always be a chair in the violin section for Ryan Rogers. So thank you very much. Bring people with you. We'd like to fill up this auditorium every time that we perform. So thank you.
get down with it, wasn't
he? Mr. How much do you remember the Morrisville Band?